Mechs have finally been nerfed, and we're going to go over that in a couple days, along with a new item coming out in Fortnite tomorrow on Tuesday, which is like a bubble shield, which is pretty cool. But over the weekend, there was a trios tournament, and a couple of my buddies qualified, Cloaksy, Tfue, and 72. 72, I was actually watching them play before I streamed, and then 72 hosted me afterwards when I was able to ask if they qualified. They got through, which is awesome. And I figured we'd do a good little analyze video over trios, because we've never done trios before. Now, if they were landing, let's pause really quick. If they were landing where I know they were landing at, I'm assuming they were. That should be Meteor. And let's go into first-person mode, right? So they're still going for Meteor. Now, their strategy for a while was Meteor to Retail. Retail is extremely OP right now because it has all the zombies. And if you break a bunch of the zombies spawners, you get a ton of good items. Like, just launch pads for days. Like a 50% chance for launch pad, I think Wildcat told me. I don't know if that's completely true. But, like, launch pads for days, golden scars, everything. So, it looks like up top here we have Cloaksy. Let me go into free mode. So what they were doing is they were landing Meteor, and if they had an opportunity, I'm sure Tfue is here trying to shoot anybody that goes into Retail. I can't switch to Tfue specifically. I can. I just got to do it the right way. Let's go to this perspective. So yeah, Tfue is trying to pressure people going into Retail from the top of this. Maybe if he gets it down, that's pretty good. And he weakened the guy a lot. So Tfue and Cloak were landing up top. Looks like 72 landed down low. And it looks like in this game, they were uncontested here at Factories, which is good because Factories is just not a big enough place to really hold two teams worth of loot. So you don't want to contest a team here. If you do, you have to wipe it quick, die off spawn, or get the kills because you're in a bad spot. This team got all assaulty alone. That's lucky. Two teams in Retail. That's pretty normal. Honestly, I think even more people should be going Retail, though. Any places that were really unlooted, it looks like? Nobody at Lucky Landing. Wow. Nobody went lucky. Looks like some people are headed for Blocks, some people headed for Pleasant. Maybe this team's headed towards Sunny as well. Interesting. So relatively spread out, but some places are entirely missed. Look like nobody went depots as well. Let's hit play and let's see. Looks like nobody went depots either. So 72, Cloak, and Tfue are here. Dusty is completely unlooted, but I bet they still take their normal transition, and they go their normal rotation, I'm sorry, from Factories here over to Retail. Because the loot in Retail is just too good to pass up. All of the mobility that it drops is too beneficial. It looks like this guy came back to loot. He floated for a minute to see where his teammates were going. He went to Dusty by himself. He's probably freaking out, though. So this is pretty good. This is pretty good. They got a solo landing here. A lot of heals off the rip. A lot of heals. Holy crap. So something that's really smart about this strategy that they do is they land Factories and they push into Retail. Even though it's outside zone, I bet they're going to push into Retail. Zone is just on the edge of Factories here. But the thing that's really smart about it is that they're mining up a lot of materials, and that's something that you can't really do easily inside of Retail. And the reason for that is because the zombies constantly pressure you, and usually if you're in Retail, you spend most of your time trying to kill the zombies to get more shield and to get more loot from them instead of actually spending your time mining materials. So they go into Retail with probably less overall, like, loot. They don't have any gold scars, gold RPGs, whatever, but they probably have a lot more material than the team that they're going up against, which means that they can easily outbuild them, which is a big, obviously, big part of the game. It looks like the team in Retail are fighting a little bit. They wiped out one guy of this team. I'm not sure who that is. And they're all sitting here together, but then Cloaksy, Tfue, and 72 are flanking them. You never know if someone's fighting in Retail, though, because if they're shooting, it doesn't mean they're shooting zombies. They could just be shooting... I mean, it doesn't mean they're shooting players. They could be shooting zombies. So you never really fully know. We'll see what happens here. We'll see if when these guys push in, if this group pushes back on them. Meanwhile, as well, this guy's solo looting Dusty depots, and this guy's at Grandma's house looking toward Factories a little sketched out because he sees build around there. So they see them pressuring a team. You wouldn't see this build against zombies. I know that's a team at that point. But this team is like way far away now. They're not going to follow that. There's no reason anyone would want to leave Retail to follow a team out when they have free access to a bunch of loot. This team is probably going for the revive bus right here to revive their friends, and no one's that lonely. So they have a fair amount of loot there as well. It looks like they're gonna try to team shot one of the players. Probably the close guy. So it looks like Skeptic. If he gets too close, they're all gonna peek at the same time and team shot him. 3, 2, 1, go. He is absolutely no health, and he got the shot. Skeptic goes down, nothing he can do. They instantly go for the BM. Now it's a 2v3. Really, really good team shot communication there. Both those guys are stacked up on top of Noms. But once they have a man up advantage, it's nothing much you can do. They have full health, but at this point, all they gotta do is kind of push them and use their man up advantage and bully them out of retail and then take all the loot from the zombie spawners. They have to have more mats than them is the thing. They do have an RPG. Looks like they're backing up. They don't want to let the RPG guy hold high ground over them, so they're backing up a little bit. Turner should probably use his splashes here. He might. Hoaxia is pretty weak as well. Gonna throw a stink bomb. He's just trying to buy time for his teammates here. He's using the stinks to just give him a second to, like, you know, move freely. Looks like the stink bombs don't connect, though. So he's giving Cloaksy time to heal up. Cloaksy's back up to 150. Turner's still at 120 himself. Even though they have the man-up advantage, they don't have the loot advantage. And because they have more mats, it doesn't necessarily give them a big advantage because they can get RPG'd down so easily. There we go. He connected with Cloaksy, got the heals off. They're focusing the guy up top. They're trying to push over the top and have high ground over him. But the Tragic's guy has no build. He's got no mats. And zombies are pressuring him from the low ground, too. So the zombies are hitting him. 72 jumps on top, gets the kill. He was out of mats entirely. And then he shoots the other guy in the back. Now they have control of retail. That was good play, good teamwork. Now all they gotta do is destroy zombie spawners. The easiest way to destroy zombie spawners is to, like, connect to a building and start mining it like this. Because the zombies can't break the whole building down before you break the spawner. But watch the loot they go from. Blue AR, green tac, 2 splashes, 1 mini, 1 launchpad. Already right there. An additional gold RPG. Big blue. And 2 more chug splashes. That thing gave 3 useful items that are all helpful and, like, extremely beneficial. They're gonna want all of that stuff. Let's see what the map looks like right now. They got one team on the hill here. They got this team over in Lonely, who's still looting in Lonely. Looks like the guy that they died, they never got his car. They just had to back out of Lonely. And Zone is pushing in. They probably have 40 seconds till it hits them. But because there's so many heals inside these zombie spawners, they might sit in storm. They want more launch pads for sure. So let's look at the loadouts right now. You got blue AR, green tac, gold RPG, 4 splashes, 1 big. On 72, you got gold combat, gray AR, 4 splashes, 6 minis. His loadout's a bit better. The shotgun's way better. Could use a better AR, but you get a lot of gold scars, so they're probably going to look for a gold scar. And then Cloaksy has a absolutely shit loadout. There's one of the gold scars we were talking about. We just improved the loadout quite a bit, but he still needs a way better shotgun. He's probably thinking of grabbing those stink bombs. He doesn't want to hold a chug jug, but he might hold the chug to heal in storm while he mines more zombie spawners out. So let's see the play here, what they're going to do. Looking at the map, these guys are pushing in late. These guys are in storm still. It looks like they are going to sit storm and wait. He built off the house, just like I said. You mine out the zombie spawner. It's pretty easy. You get a bunch of loot off of it. He has 1 launch pad. Turner had 1 launch pad. I wonder if it glitches. Yeah, so it glitches when you switch people. So I think they all have actually 1 launch pad at the very least. So they might. Yeah, he's going to use the slurp juice and heal, then grab the med kit probably. And he's leaving this other, not slurp juice, I'm sorry, chug jug. He's leaving this other chug jug for another teammate while they continue to break stuff and sit in the storm. They're not too far, so it's not too bad. He's going to have to help out Tom. Here we go. Good plays. These guys are trying to skirt the edge of retail right now. I think they're probably looking for more loot themselves. They have no clue someone's in storm with them, so this could be really bad. But this group probably doesn't want to engage on them. There's no way I would want to try to challenge a group that's been sitting in retail mining up a bunch of high-tier loot off zombies, and at the same time, they have a man-up advantage on me. I would never want to fight that, ever. So they probably won't mess with them. Another med kit there, another chug jug. Cloaksy will use that chug, probably. Maybe not, okay. Ops for the med kit. Asking his buddies to shoot the zombies, pushing him so he has time to get the heal off. Good call. Good comms, good comms. It looks like they roll out now. Zombie spawners drop a lot of loot though, a lot of really good loot. I'm sure they have campfires, launch pads, maybe a regular trap. A lot of campfire launch pad combos though. So they probably have enough campfires to heal up to max once they walk out of the storm here. And their loot is insane. I mean, look, gold scar, gold RPG, on 72, gold combat, gold RPG. Gray AR kind of sucks, but it's not bad. It's not, you know, it's not horrible. Turner's rocking the green tack, gold RPG as well, and a gold infantry. All of them have two sets of heals as well. The loot is insane, obviously, from zombies and competitive. I don't know. I mean, if it was me, I can't believe there's not like five teams contesting that spot. It looks like they're 280 above the Storm Surge as well, which is good. Because Storm Surge, obviously, if you don't know what it is, I'll explain here in a second. But Storm Surge is glitched, where even if you're not above it and you do damage and you're below it, it can still be glitched and not like get you above it fully. But Storm Surge is basically a way to try to encourage fighting in competitive. In competitive, you play very slowly. Usually, teams that don't engage don't risk very much. So they try to encourage the engagements by making Storm Surge a thing where if you're not above a certain damage threshold at certain points in the game, if there are too many people alive, you will basically take damage until there are not enough people alive where Storm Surge would go away. On second zone like this, it's 70. So when the player amount goes below 70, Storm Surge will drop off. On the next zone, I think it's 50. So I don't know a whole lot about Storm Surge, mainly because I've never had an issue with it. I usually play aggressive enough where I either have enough damage or I die. So Storm Surge just dropped off, less than 70 people. They shouldn't have to worry. First Storm Surge, if you've wiped a full team, you should be perfectly fine. By the second Storm Surge, you're probably going to want a few more tags. Storm Surge doesn't really happen super often in solos and duos, but it does happen much more when you have more people on your team. So trios and squads. And that's because the loot is more, it's more shareable. Like, if you have, let's see, two teams land salty, three people are going to die. But if you have six people land salty in solos, there's probably going to be more than three that die, probably four or five. So people are wiped out quicker in solos versus in trios. Just an example. All right, they got to rotate in quite a bit. They do not want to go past this team on the hill. They probably have enough launches to just use a launch pad, but at the same time, the launch pad will probably get them shot. There's a group on the house here. This is the group that was inside lonely. It's a 2v3. They don't know it's a 2v3, though. They think it's a full 3. They're probably going to try to get over here to the lip and go all the way around, which seems like a really long rotation, but it is probably the safest. My bad. Let's go back to them. I hit the wrong key. Looks like this team moved off the mountain, so they can go over the mountain if they want as well. They probably don't know they moved off the mountain now. It's all about how much information you have as well as, like, what we're watching. We obviously have way more information watching in this mode and replay mode, but the thing is, if you waited and you tried to push in behind this team can just hold you forever. Same with this team. So they don't want to spend their time trying to be stuck in between these two people. So they're going to burn a launch pad and go all the way around this mountain and come down through the river. Oh, they're going to go up top. Never mind. I take it back. Okay. It's okay too. It's not bad. I figured they would kind of go down low and follow the launch pad in, but I guess they didn't want to use a launch pad and stay in the air for too long. They just wanted to use it to be a little bit quicker. So they're rotating in late, but they're rotating in late behind teams that don't know they're there. So they can't really be storm held. That is a shit show to look at right there. They might be able to pick up a few picks here. Pick up a few picks. They might be able to get a couple kill steals. God, the replay mode is just buggier than shit. They're all relatively full health. They might use a launch pad. I don't know if they will. Oh, they're going to. Are they going to launch over the river? This can be bad. Launching out in the air like this can usually result in some hits, so you might lose some HP. Alright. Well, they got away from that little engagement here. They didn't want to get involved with the people fighting. They wanted to stay, play for late game. They're looking for some rockets, some third parties, but I don't know if it's worth it. They also might want to go high ground. They've used two launch pads so far, but I'm sure they have more. So they RPG'd that team to give them free space to build over without being contested, where if you try to build over while they're not trying to dodge the rocket or rebuild their base, they might pressure you. So that's, you've seen multiple examples here of when they used RPGs and stink bombs to, it's like spacing. You know, they're trying to open up a space for them to be able to push for high ground or to try to push safely. If you stink bomb a team or if you RPG a team, they have to worry about rebuilding their base or getting out of the stink to not take damage or not get killed instead of spending that time focusing on you while you're rotating or while you're building up. That's essentially what they're doing there, which is a really good play. They're using a launch pad to go for high ground. This is the third launch pad. They might want to land high ground and then shoot it out. I don't know. This is a pretty good spot, though. So they're right on the south side of Storm. They have the high ground on top of the hill. They're going to be looking for people across the river here that are going to be launching to hit them. They might also look over here, but because these people are not in a position to like rotate in without... if they're going to rotate toward them, yeah, but they can rotate here through Shifty. So these guys probably won't be able to get pressured. These guys are the people they're going to look for. These guys, they can't really shoot. They're already in zone. They're waiting for people to rotate as well. So they're going to look toward river for picks here. He's dropping a chug jug up top so he can go down and grab a shotgun. Ooh, he found loot. That's why. Okay, nice. Well, that's definitely better loot for him. So there's the river team they're looking for. He's going to spend most of his time looking for them, probably. You can't focus the people by Shifty. It's just not an open line of sight. He also might build a second ramp facing toward the other hill so they can block off. Have to wait and see. They have a chug jug up top, which is great. They think they're there, but they're not. They're much lower down. They have really good mats right now, though, too. I can tell because if extra brick is sitting there, they have to have a lot of extra material. Well, not extra, but like they have to be basically full mats, which is really good in this position. So everything about this game is good. They're in a decent position. Not amazing, but a decent position. They're above the storm surge again. They have fantastic loot with RPGs, combats, gold scars. They have a bunch of launch pads for mobility. They have a ton of healing. Looks like River team just shockwaved across. So to that team, they just team shockwaved too. Everyone from River just team shockwaved in. So they didn't have a chance to really go for a kill there. But they can still spray them down that they're on low ground. That's what they're doing right now. Looks like the team at Shifty ended up launching back toward them. That was not the way they wanted to go. The team at Shifty is in trouble. That is definitely not what they wanted to do. Obviously, again, after the fact, using replay mode, we can tell that, but they probably didn't know. They might have thought this was the only way, and the reason for that is because Shifty was so congested. They probably didn't want to try to push through all these teams. Instead, they think this is more open. The only issue is these teams loaded up right here can only focus them, really. So, the triple rocket. Oh, it didn't kill him, though. The triple RPG. That's insane. They might be able to triple RPG through all of this even. I'm curious if they get people with the triple RPG. That's just crazy. The fact that you even have three RPGs is crazy. Zombies are just so OP. They're so good for like the just high tier loot. They got really good luck on zone though. They might be able to just, they're gonna tarp in. I don't think they're not gonna go low ground. They're gonna build in from here. The thing is, if you look down here on the map, this little part of the hill is in zones, so people will be able to get up a little bit higher, but they're going to have the high ground for sure. And a lot of teams are not close enough to use impulses or shockwaves to get in the zone. So they're going to use launch pads here. They're going to pick off people in the air. Looks like people are fighting down low. A lot of people clumped up there, two full squads. They want to shoot RPGs, but they don't want to waste RPG ammo. They're going to look for people flying right now. Watch for launch padders. Looks like Snood's WIFO and those guys are using Shockwave still. They still had the launch pad. Now they're in the air. Folks gets sniped. Instantly he goes for the peak. They're still looking for picks though. Oh, it's so laggy. Uses the chug jug to get back fully. His buddies are spraying him right now. 72 are I can't watch him. I'd like to switch, but it won't switch to the right player. They're shooting down high ground. And they're tarping in right now. They got zone again, though. This game wants them to win. This zone was really nice for them, and then this zone pulls back on their own build, and they have the high ground. So this is insane. Let's switch over to a different player that we've been watching for a while. Let's switch to Tfue here. Actually, who has the most limbs on their team right now? Tfue and... Yeah, let's watch Tfue and 72. They both have limbs, so let's watch Tfue. He's got the infantry rifle. Only two rockets left. Zone is so beneficial for him. They're going to try to get back up on high ground here. They don't want to like let anybody try to like launch and take it over, so... The thing is, they seem really high up, but they're not. Because they're on a hill, so they're really not that far off the ground. They're shooting out launch pads right now so people can't rotate in easily. Storm starts to move, they're gonna look for people launching. That guy's gonna die. I cannot believe he did not get killed. They still have the damage threshold, they're looking at Nate, they know Nate's gonna launch here. Oh shit, someone built up behind him, that was not what they wanted. He rocketed him out. He might go for the edit play. He's not going to go for the edit play. He's telling his teammates to get down right now. All right, they cut him out. They cut him out. They got the high ground back. This is scary, though. This is a scary part. So they were high up because, well, they weren't high up because they were on a hill. But because the zone goes off the hill, they're going to be really high up really quickly. So all the players that are building out right now are going to have to drop a lot. So Tfue is the one extending out right now. They have a launch pad up high. They have no way to protect themselves from fall damage other than people below them. If someone uses, I don't know if junk rifts are in this. I don't think they are, but if they are, it's going to cut out everybody. They're in a decent spot still. They got to drop lower real quick here. Turner knows he has to go lower. It's way too high up. It's so high up right now. Thankfully, there's a couple people below them in full metal as well. That's why he's not too worried about it, but... Yeah, I think he still wants to drop a bit. He wants to come down on Cloaksy's level, I think. Maybe they want to be on multiple levels. Might be the play, I don't know. Normally, so... The reason normally you would not want to be on the same level is because you're scared of one of your levels getting cut. And if it does get cut, then you have multiple levels to back up with. But... The only problem with that is if you are on different levels, you basically have to expend two times the mats because you're not able to be together and only use one set of materials to tarp. So, that guy died in a storm. They might go for the kill real quick. See, right there, someone tried to cut him out. they're a little high up. Looks like somebody fell down. Cloak fell down, lost a decent amount of health. He might rebuild up to Tfue here, which will mean that he's connected again. Looks like Cloak is trying to build up a little bit. Turner is still on ultimate high by a ways. There we go. He dropped a little bit. That's better. This is way more manageable here. Way more manageable. Who's on the high ground? Who's that? Is that Tom? Hold up. Drone free. I'm in the middle of storm. Of course, I love drone free. Look where I am. Yeah, I'm over at Meteor. This is really useful since all the players are over here. This is so beneficial. Replay mode is working perfectly as intended. Let's go over really quick. I want to see who is on the high ground. Of course, and I hit the wrong button. Well, yeah, that's not what I wanted. I want to be in drone free mode. And not inside the storm a mile away. I hit C on accident, which switched. It is Tom. Tom's on the high ground of the other mountain. That's pretty legit. Man, a lot of people are back in storm right there. Well, this will be interesting. Let's go back to the gameplay point of view then. So laggy. He goes down. So he's on his last bit of materials there. Okay, he still has 400 actually. I was going to say, why is he building with wood? He must just be on wood and be like, all right, this is good enough. Normally you want to go to brick. He's out of AR. I was like, why is he shooting a shotgun? He has no AR ammo. All right, let's switch over instead to 72. It looks like he probably still has some AR left. Did that click on 72? There we go. Oh, he has one AR bullet. How about Cloaksy? Cloaksy's got three AR bullets. They're all out of AR ammo. All three of them. All right, let's watch Tom now. That's hilarious. They're all out of AR. That's crazy. Crazy. They're going for wall takes because they want to go for AR ammo here, so. Tom has 200 metal left. He's trying to pressure these guys and take the AR ammo off of them, but the thing is, Tom does have a combat. The combat has a lot of range to it, so you can sit, you know, high ground and combat people for 30, 40, 50 still instead of having to use an AR. I'm not sure how many limbs do they have. Let's pause really quickly as well. Let's see the limb count right now. Between 72, they have 4, 6, 7. It's not bad at all. It's not like a 40 kill game, but you know, 7 is still good. Stacked lobby as well. Oh, the lag is real. So now Tom's abusing his shotgun. He's doing like 40, 50s. Cloak is on the high ground. Looks like Tfue and 72 are the ones pressuring. Oh, he got nothing out of that, really. He's going for the elims. So the play here, this was actually really smart. All these guys couldn't build up. Look at all this loot. They couldn't build up the mountain. The way this was moving, it was kind of just screwing over everybody down low. They had to go for elims. But because 72 and Tfue wanted to get more kills for the points, they wanted to jump down. And the way they did this was really smart, I should point out, because they left Cloak on the high ground to stay inside zone so he would not... God, everything is... I hate replay mode. This replay mode absolutely is terrible. How did I just get back to that point? I don't even know. Go to the end game, please. I'm trying to show something, and this is just trash. It's trash. Drone free. There we go. Drone free. So they left Cloak right here, right? I'm going to zoom up just like this and watch down. They leave Cloaksy on the ultimate high ground with enough materials to at least base in and stay in zone. And when that happens, they both jump down and go for the elims to get extra points for their squad. So it's really smart. It's smart. It's basically trying to optimize the amount of points that you can get within a game. You know, you send two guys down low for the elims. You don't know how many are alive, but you're hoping that they die because they're basically going to be stuck in storm. And then you let your last guy just follow the storm in and stay inside zone. And so in case the people who go down low actually do die, at least you have one dude still inside circle who's not taking any damage, and he should win the game regardless. So very smart. Very good play. That was a really good game. Out of the fact they ran out of AR ammo, I don't know how they ran out of AR ammo. I think they had quite a bit. And they even killed zombies, which gives you a lot of extra ammo. But 9 kill win. Solid. Solid. They had a lot of launch pads. I doubt they used all their launch pads. They came from factories to retail towards Salty, around here to Shifty on top of the hill. And then they basically just maintained high ground because they got lucky zone right here. Lucky zone right here. It was on them twice in a row on moving zones. And that just rewarded them hugely. I mean, someone did try to take high ground, but they cut them out. They took high ground back. So they did maintain the high ground, which was good. But the zones right here next to Shifty helped them a lot. These two back-to-back that were on them, lifesavers. It means they didn't have to use any shockwaves. They didn't have to use any launch pads. They could just hold the high ground. And if anybody went for the high ground take, they could shockwave up, break all the build, knock them down. But don't think that ever happened. Hope you guys enjoyed, though. Analyze video. If you guys want to follow any of their socials, if you don't follow them already, links in the description as always. And I will see you guys next time. Thank you for watching.